Joel Senyonyi, the leader of opposition and other legislators, were barred from accessing the construction site of Lwowa International Hospital, where they went for an oversight visit yesterday.
The relevant authorities.
That's which ministry?
Ministry of Health, compared to other relevant authorities.
Which ones are funded?
Including Parliament, sure.
Including Parliament?
We are Parliament.
Yes, you are, but we need a clearance. They cleared the document.
Cleared by who?
How can we prove at this moment that it is valid?
How are you able to prove that it is not valid?
While kicking off today's House sitting, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, condemned the blocking of members of Parliament from executing their mandate of oversight on a project where government has injected huge sums of taxpayers' money. Among disclosed that she has asked the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayeba, to visit the hospital site to establish the progress of the project.
I am told the team was denied access to see what is happening, where our money has gone. And I think that is really very unfortunate, because we are doing what we are mandated to do. As per the Constitution, we are doing our oversight role. So I think as government, you need to guide us. Should we just sit here, appropriate money, we don't see what is being done, and we call it a day? Remember, this is taxpayers' money that we must account for.
The Attorney General Chiyowa Chiwanuka was quizzed to explain why the site is becoming a no-go zone for Parliament.
Still part of the role of Parliament, or it was corrupt of.
When I saw on TV a big team of members of Parliament who were denied to enter and see, and that was belittling Parliament. At the same time, it also reminded me about the English that we used to study when we were in primary, where we talk about Abdul. I think they are sealing it off and nobody should go there because it's a ghost.
About this Lwowa incident, because it's not the first time that Parliament is going there and they are denied. I remember some time back, even the Committee of Health went and they were denied. The question that we should ask ourselves, the question that government should answer is this facility there? Is it being constructed?
It should be recalled that in March 2019, Parliament approved the request by the Minister of Finance to issue promissory notes for the construction of Lwowa Hospital, valued at $379.71 million, approximately 1.442 trillion shillings. And the project was to be delivered in 2 years. However, 5 years later, the construction has remained stuck on the foundation.
When we secured 396 billion shillings to facilitate that work to start, the work was supposed to be concluded in 2 years, had to be handed over to the government of Uganda after 8 years, and I don't know if that contract still stands.
And even legally, or promissory notes. Before another promissory note is issued, the contractor is meant to give
certificate.
A certificate of milestone completion.
Yes.
And that's the accountability we want. So far, why do you keep issuing promissory notes?
Maybe we need to get the certificates of the milestone completion.
The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasi, is shocked Parliament to reveal that the government has so far sunk $156 million, approximately 616.4 billion shillings in the project, which attracted queries on the cost of the project.
Madam Speaker, the total project cost under Lwowa Hospital is 379 million US dollars.
The third Deputy Prime Minister, Rukia Isanga Nakadama, committed on behalf of government to act on the matter immediately.
Right, Honorable, it is sad that, that members of parliament were denied to enter Rubowa. I'm going to look into that matter with the Minister of Health, because this, the members had a letter from the Minister of Health. So we are going to look into the matter so that members should access that area.
Report compiled by Fred Kajiri for the news.